Hi there, I'm attorney Chuck Shire. You know our law firm, Shire and Ritchie. You can call us at 839-2024 or you can find us on the web at srtriallawyers.com. Now, a lot of you know us as lawyers who help injured people. People have been injured in an accident, but we also help people in criminal court as well. And today we're going to address that question that I hear all the time from non-lawyers or even lawyers who don't do the same work that I do. And that is, how can you represent people in criminal court? How can you represent somebody who is charged with a crime? What if you know this person is guilty? So I get that question often, and in today's video, I want to try to educate the public a little bit about what some people refer to as criminal defense, and really even in our marketing materials we refer to it as criminal defense. But the first most important point to make is that this really isn't about criminal defense. What we really need to do is address how we refer to folks who are in court charged with a crime, and that's more of a civil rights issue. Okay, so the majority of our work is really focused on the civil rights aspect of it with regards to this word, fairness. So just keep in mind, the majority of what we're doing is focused on making sure that the process is fair. Yes, there's an element of guilt and innocence to it, but oftentimes we want to make sure that that process is fair. Let me give you a couple of examples. With regards to a sentencing, so let's talk about a sentencing. Should a person go to prison? Should they go to jail? Should they get probation? If so, how long? Should there be certain terms to that probation, whether it's certain treatment, certain classes, should they have to get a GED, should they have to stay employed? All these different types of things is what traditionally known as criminal defense lawyers are focused on. It's what we're focused on every single day when we're representing somebody. So other things might be public service or a fine. One of the big things that courts look at is the impact of a sentence on dependents. So we spend time preparing our clients for ultimately a sentencing hearing and argue to the court what an impact might be on their dependents, on their family. So keep in mind that it's not always about guilt or innocence or, okay, you're going to get somebody off who might be guilty. It's not always about that. The United States justice system is the best in the world, and mainly because there is this focus on fairness, that you do have lawyers and judges who are trying to make sure that this process is fair. Now, does the system work all the time? No, of course not. It doesn't. You do have issues. O.J. Simpson, I'm sure, is a very popular example. But by and large, the work of defense lawyers are there to make sure, to the extent they can, that every single defendant is treated the exact same way and that they are treated fairly. And that's kind of how we see our role. Another thing that you need to consider is how evidence is collected. So you do see this routinely, that you'll have individuals who their house is searched, or they're stopped and their car is searched. All those different types of things. There are rules that govern this, and defense lawyers make sure those rules are followed. And when those rules are not followed, it's only the defense lawyer that brings this to the attention of the court. And I want you to think about that, because sometimes law enforcement will, and maybe they think the ends justify the means, but don't always, dot their I's, cross their T's. And somebody's, constitutional rights can be violated. And it's only the defense lawyer who calls them on that. If they break that those rules and violate the constitutional rights, then sometimes that evidence can't be used. So remember, it's not always a question of guilt or innocence. Although that is the question I get all the time is, well, what if you know that the person is guilty? How do you represent them? But there's something that you should really keep in mind, that guilt or innocence is not judged by the belief of their lawyer. It's judged by the jury, 12 people from your community who sits down and hears all the evidence. And in that process, there are rules as well. There are rules that govern how the evidence is presented to the jury and what the jury sees and what arguments can be made, what inferences can be drawn from the evidence. So keep that in mind as well. Who looks out for that person who is in criminal court and the state is presenting all this evidence? The only people are the defense lawyers. And so in a sense, the defense lawyer really is the person that stands between the process being fair or unfair, or between the United States system and, say, a police state in another country. So just keep that in mind, that we are out there. We take that role very serious, and we try to make sure that the process is fair for every single one of our clients. And that starts on day one, the day that you hire your lawyer, and we come in and we review all that evidence with you, because we are in this together with our clients. We want them to know that we have reviewed it and that the process is going to be fair, that they're going to be treated fairly, so that we can get to the best possible legal outcome for them, considering their circumstances. Again, I'm Chuck Shire with the law firm Shire & Ritchie, 839-2024, or on the web at srtriallawyers.com. Thanks for joining me.